guys, Turbocharge 51 over here! I hope you're having a splendid day wherever you are in the world. And guys, it is time for round number 19 here at Mexico for the Mexican Grand Prix. Quick look at the performance chart. You guys can see Mercedes is still eking out Ferrari at the top, with Red Bull catching up very quickly at this stage of the season. Renault and Haas have jumped me now in the performance chart. They are ahead of me again. I am still ahead of Force India and McLaren, who are neck and neck with each other. And Williams are no longer the weakest car on the grid. They have surpassed Sauber, and Sauber is now the weakest team on the grid. But guys, unfortunately I've got a little bit of bad news. The sound of this video, at the end of the video, you guys will hear with the racing. This sound is like 1 second out of bounds with the image. But there's nothing I can do about that. There was a little bit of a mistake by the recording. I'm sorry about that. And other than that, the bad news is, because of the regulation change and me focusing on adapting the upgrades, the other teams have passed me again. But next season, we'll see how strong this little Toro Rosso really is. But let's head to qualifying.
Welcome back to the Autodromo Hermanos Rodriguez circuit, where qualifying will begin shortly. And as we wait, poised for the start of what will hopefully be a thrilling qualifying, why don't you tell us, Anthony Davidson, about the things you can do to really get the most out of a car in a session like this?
Well, you're largely limited by the Parc Fermé regulations, of course. Back in the old days, pre-2004, you'd work on both a qualifying setup and a race setup over practice, and then swap them over after qualifying. So the race car was quite different at times to the qualifying car. Nowadays, though, you have to find a compromise that works for both. There are a few things that you can still adjust during the session, such as the differential, the brake bias, and the front wing angle, but that's about it. So it's more about optimizing what you do have and adapting your own style to suit the track conditions.
Right, it's not going to be easy getting into the next qualifying session, but we know you'll give it your all.
So we're here in the pit box ready for the Mexican qualifying. And I have to be honest, guys, you guys know the championship margin is not much. Sergio Perez and myself are neck and neck, as well as both Ferraris and the Mercedes of Lewis Hamilton. You guys know, with the previous Grand Prix, the American Grand Prix, it went quite well for, I would have to say, for Sebastian Vettel, not so much for Lewis. But this fight is still very much on with all three of them, and my fight with Sergio Perez is also quite a heated up fight. And because I'm the player, my fight's gonna get a little bit more shine than the fight at the front. But like I said, as when I started these videos, guys, you guys will always have the battle at the front, so you guys can know how everything is going there and not just have to focus on me the entire time. But we complete two laps here at Mexico, and we are standing at a 1:14.5, going back into the garage, strapping on a new set of ultra softs, getting the fuel down to the absolute minimum to see how we can do for our final lap. We are already P14, and by the end of the session we are still P14, which actually looks very good. But we were going, we had to get out of Quali 1. You guys know how bad I need to get out of Quali 1. It's in my contract. I can't just go willy-nilly in qualifying anymore. I have to work for it. But we head here onto the lap, and guys, let me take you around a lap here in Mexico. I think it's not just time. No, it's not time just yet. But I actually gave it away there. We go around the final corner, and I'm going to cross the line with a 1:15. I can't remember what. But guys, I shimmy through on my butt cheeks. I am just into Quali 2, but the fact of the matter is, we are in. We strap on the set we used. La 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 la. Sorry for the tongue twister. We strap on the set that we used at the end of Quali 1 to set our first lap in Quali 2. And guys, with all due respect, this Toro Rosso car sucks with the Hypersoft tires. No matter, it were in Monaco. Some of the other races were in Monaco. What other race has the ultra the Hypersoft tires? I can't remember if Canada, Montreal has it, but I know Abu Dhabi, this Mexico track. But there's a few, Singapore, my car sucks with the Hypersoft tires, like it completely sucks. All the harder compound tires, ultra soft, soft, super soft, mediums. It's good on those tires, but it doesn't like this Hypersoft compound. I just don't know, not overheating, it's just I cremate the tires at the back so quickly, but you never know. Maybe if I get the chassis at a better stage later on in the career, the car will handle the ultra soft, hyper soft, better. But guys, now we head on to a lap here at the Mexican track. I'm not going to try and pronounce this track's name, it's just way too hard. We head here onto this very long home straight, my favorite part of the track, loose hands. Not my favorite corner, my favorite part of the track. We head here to this first corner nearly at 350 km/h. It's a triple chicane, for those of you guys that only know miles an hour. 350 km/h is around about 217-218 miles an hour. We head here down the back straight, open DRS into overtake on the ERS, brake as late and as hard as you can for this next left hander, and then the right hander, I call this a chicane. The next corner is a double right hander, very tight corner indeed. Second gear, try to climb over the second curve, I just miss it, but I clip the apex perfectly. We go here into this S section, it's also a 4S section. If you carry enough speed through here, you can get exceptional lap times, and you just feel like a boss. Boom, boom, boom. Through the S's, we go here down this final little piece into the final part of the track, the stadium section, down to third gear to get the car to turn in. Fourth gear, stop the car from oversteering, down to second gear for another very tight left hander. Right hander next, and a little left kink into the final corner, which is the right hander here. Open the throttle as early as possible, but don't get the car to oversteer. Hug the inside to get the quickest possible lap time. And guys, what's the time going to be? No! Why? That was so close! Oh, 2/10 away from being in the top 10. 2/10. 2/10. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? It's not the end of the world. Guys, let's head to the Mexican Grand Prix!
Formula One may have been absent from Mexico for 23 years, but after 2015's triumphant return, it was as if we'd never been away. In Mexico, a Grand Prix is more than just a race. It's a celebration of speed and of bravery. There's nothing quite like the atmosphere in the stadium today. They'll be drowning out the cars with their noise as they make their way through on lap one. We're a long way above sea level here in Mexico today, which could pose some cooling issues for the cars as they make their way around this 2.6 mile lap. 17 corners with top speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour, and watch out for potential overtaking into turns 1 and 4. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. We have a really close scrap at the top of the championship at the moment, and now could be disastrous. They must be starting to feel the pressure at this point, and surely there's a real shot at the title on the cards here, but one error at the wrong time, well, that could throw it all away.
True enough, but that pressure goes both ways. A failure or a mistake at this point could spell the end of their championship hopes, but they know their rivals are in exactly the same situation. Let's just hope the title is decided in the purest of ways.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Ricciardo, Sergio Perez, and Hülkenberg, Sainz, O'Connor, Raikkonen. They've taken a grid penalty. And Charles Leclerc, Sirotkin, Ericsson, Romain Grosjean, and Alonso, Gasly, Van Dorn, Lance Stroll, and Max Verstappen. Ocon and Kevin Magnussen rounds off the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
You should have some space going into the first corner, so try to keep it tidy.
So we are on the grid for the Mexican Grand Prix, and guys, a two-stop was not going to work for me. We're going one stop all the way, and as you guys saw with the penalties, I'm in P8, my rival Perez is in P6. This was going to be a fist fight all the way to the end. Wait, am I P8 or am I P9? I can't remember, but all I know is I can see Perez in the left side of my car. But guys, jam with me, let's go to the Mexican Grand Prix.
Thank you.
rest of the grid is forming up, be patient and watch for the lights.
I hope you guys are excited for this Mexican Grand Prix, because I can tell you surely that I am. This is going to be amazing. We head to 5 red lights. Kimi's got a penalty. Lewis and Sebastian is on the front row. Let's see what happens. And let's go, go, go for the Mexican Grand Prix. The two Mercedes get excellent starts off of the line. But Vettel and Boxstad is under pressure from Bottas and from Daniel Ricciardo. You can see that Daniel pulls out alongside Sebastian. Let's see what Sebastian does into the first corner. He's late onto the brakes. He defends from Valtteri and from Daniel. He is not taking any prisoners this Grand Prix. Vettel knows he has to win every Grand Prix from the previous one, which was in America, all the way to the end if he wants to take this championship home. But it's Lewis Hamilton leading the way from Sebastian Vettel and Valtteri Bottas and Daniel Ricciardo in fourth. You guys can see there's a little scrap between me and Nico Hülkenberg in the background, but we'll jump to that in a second. Don't worry about that. We won't leave that out of bounds. It is Hamilton leading the way from Sebastian Vettel, Valtteri Bottas and Daniel Ricciardo. This race is already heating up a lot. But as you guys see, Lewis is on the purple sidewall, ultra soft tire. He qualified on the ultra soft. Most of the people else in the top 10 are on hyper soft tire, so they are going to pit much, much earlier than Lewis. Lewis is going for a one-stop strategy like myself, and Lewis is going to push with everything he had. But Vettel was going to have to pass him before they head for the pit stops. Otherwise, Lewis is going to have the upper hand this entire race, and that is not what you want to give that the Brit of Lewis Hamilton. He will punish you if you give him any advantage. We head here onto the POV of Roman Grosjean at the very start of the Grand Prix again, who's battling away with Charles Leclerc and Kimi Raikkonen. But Grosjean gets the squeeze from Leclerc, who gets squeezed by Raikkonen, and Raikkonen is right up in this fight. He is behind the Williams of Lance Stroll, who also had an exceptional start. Unfortunately, I can't go through every car start of the Grand Prix, guys, because then the video will just be the start of a Grand Prix and it will be quite boring, to be honest with you guys. But Kimi is ahead of the Sauber of Charles Leclerc. Now we jump onto my POV for the start of the Mexican Grand Prix, and we are go, go, go for the Mexican Grand Prix. Let's go, baby. Seperates gets held up, gets a very bad start and holds up Carlos Sainz. I'm right behind the other Renault of Nico Hülkenberg, trying to steal the slipstream. Overtake on the ERS is selected. I can tell you guys that he goes to the inside. He gives me a massive door. I give him a little bit of a bump on the left front wheel, just a little tap, not a big bump. But I am through into 5th position from 8th position. This is a very, very good start. But Nico Hülkenberg, as you guys saw with the beginning of the race with the front runners, he is pressuring me hefty, hefty, hefty. And he is right there. But I give him a little bit of a squeeze. I go in front of him. And we are in P5. Ooh, I go very wide there. You guys saw nothing. You saw nothing. In any case, we are heading on to the rest of this lap. I'm still behind Daniel Ricciardo. I actually tried to see if I could stay with these guys, because I knew Hamilton was on the ultra soft, but I still knew that was a Mercedes car. But you guys can't blame a guy for dreaming, and can't blame a guy for trying. I mean, come on, come on. And I'm telling you guys, next season I will be with these guys. What's it with me at going wide? I just went wide with another corner there. Come on, get yourself together. Woohoo! Big kick of oversteer there. We head here through the final corner and stuff is looking very juicy. Very juicy. Onto the home straight with Nico Hülkenberg breathing down my neck. And he pulls out. Is that Renault going to have the power to compete with the Honda power in the back of my Toro Rosso? As you guys know, I made a lot of upgrades to the engine. I'm no longer the third strongest engine, but I am still one of the strongest. I think I'm like fifth. But I keep my position away from Nico Hülkenberg, because I knew this position was going to help me a lot. And Sergio Perez was right behind Nico in 7th position. We head here onto lap 4, and as you guys can see, Sergio has caught up to us, and the front 4 have started running away from us. I was starting to feel immense pressure from from Nico at this stage. I am so excited for the front battle, guys. You guys have no idea. I can't wait to see what transpires with those front runners. I think the battle is going to be immense. But as you guys see here, I pass Nico quite easily. And at this stage, Daniel Ricciardo and Valtteri Bottas are battling away for P3. This is the final podium position, and I'm sure Daniel would like nothing more than to be in front of this Mercedes, and he makes a successful move. But Valtteri immediately dives into the pit lane, and he is going for his pit stop, the first of the front runners to come into the pit lane. So Valtteri is going for a major undercut, and let's see if it works out for Valtteri. He just needs to hope he doesn't come out in traffic. And also the flying Finn himself, Kimi Raikkonen, comes in for his pit stop as the Mercedes crew go back into their garage. There's a Williams also coming into the pit, but that's not important. As you guys see, we head on to the end of lap 9, and Sebastian Vettel is also coming into the pit. He has got a very hefty fight ahead of him because he couldn't pass Lewis in the front, well, in the beginning phases of this Grand Prix. He goes on to a set of ultra soft tires, and also Daniel Ricciardo comes in and straps on his set of ultra soft tires. So these two guys were going for a two-stop strategy, not a one-stop. Sergio Perez, my rival, also came in for his pit stop, and guys, he was also on a two-stop, not a one-stop. The two-stop is a very aggressive strategy here at Mexico because we have the softest compounds of tires available in the season. But we head here onto lap 12 with Sebastian Vettel being behind me now that I haven't pit yet. I just let him pass, guys. There was no point in me holding up Sebastian because, I mean, really, my fight's not with him. Next season, it might be. But we head here onto the next lap, lap 13, at the end of lap 13, beginning of lap 14. And it was then the turn of Daniel Ricciardo just to come past me, my senior Red Bull team. And I have to be honest, I poached DRS off of him for about a 2 laps. That was quite fun. We head here onto lap 17. And guys, at this stage, I can tell you, poor Valtteri Bottas once again had a problem with his car. The previous race, he broke his front wing. This race, it was a mechanical issue. There is just nothing Valtteri can do to get stuff going his way. Ooh, Kimi locks up a bit there, but Kimi has passed him, and at this stage, guys, Valtteri was really starting to go onto the back foot, and I can tell you guys, I think Valtteri was so frustrated, it's not even funny. But on lap 15, we got Lewis Hamilton, the race leader, is coming into the pit, as well as myself. And guys, I have to tell you, at this stage, the race was so hyped. It was just like, my fight was with Leclerc, very smart turbo. My fight was with Perez, and I was doing everything just to stay consistent, because you guys know consistency is what takes home the cake at the end of the day. Here you guys see we are right up the chuff of Valtteri Bottas as well. My teammate Pierre Gasly is, I am right behind Pierre, who is still who has already pit from his hypers to his ultras, but he is going in for a second stop. I have to be honest, my car, even though the super soft tires are the hardest compound this weekend, my car had exceptional pace on those super soft tires. And I have to be honest, it was a joy to drive on those super soft tires, and those red tires on the Toro Rosso, they just look brilliant. But as you guys see, Gasly passed Bottas, and it wasn't long after that I also made the move. I wasn't going to risk the chance of being stuck behind Bottas, because as you guys see there, right behind is Max Verstappen. And yeah, it would have been stupid from my side just to stay behind him and steal DRS the entire time. And I have to be honest, Valtteri was very slow. But here comes Sebastian Vettel for his second pit stop. I'm sure Vettel at this stage was just going to bolt for Hamilton. But guys, one thing that I can't understand for the life of me, you guys see Hamilton passes Ricciardo. Sebastian Vettel had to keep his tires going for about 4 or 5 more laps. Okay, no, 3 laps more. Then Sebastian could have strapped on a second set of ultra soft tires, which are softer than the tires Hamilton is on, and they would have been fresher than Hamilton's harder super soft. But Vettel strapped on a set of super soft tires, the hardest compound for here for this weekend. So at this stage, Vettel was not going to catch Hamilton because he would not have enough pace. And you guys will see just in a second, Daniel Ricciardo goes for a pit and he straps on the ultra soft tires because he stretched his tires about 2-3 laps later. I don't know what Vettel's idea was there, but it was not a smart decision from Ferrari, if I have to be honest. Just quickly here, guys, I leached a bit off of Pierre Gasly, my teammate, for about 4 laps. I just kept stealing DRS from him to get the high top end. But guys, look here. Sergio Perez has come into the pit lane, and as you guys saw on the outside of the screen, the two Toro Rosso have passed this Force India, and I am now well ahead of that Force India. So if I don't finish in front of him, it's going to be because of my own stupidity and my own bad driving. But as I said, I love this track, and the track is fun to drive. But guys, here's what I talked about. Look, it's Daniel Ricciardo. He comes in ultra soft to ultra soft. He already used the hyper soft tire, so he is safe for the tire strategy. And now, at this stage, Daniel was starting to catch Sebastian. But we head on to the end of lap 25, beginning of lap 26. Let's just quickly run through the top 10. Lewis Hamilton is still dominating this Grand Prix in the front. Sebastian Vettel is still in second place, but very, very slowly catching Lewis Hamilton. Not fast enough to try and challenge for the lead, so he has to hope Lewis has a problem. Then we have Daniel Ricciardo here in third, who at this stage was catching Sebastian, so indirectly was catching Lewis. Myself, woohoo, was in fourth position at this stage, going for my best finish yet in the F1 2018 season, well, my first season. And as you guys see, I'm right in front of Charles Leclerc in the Sauber, who is fifth. He is on the same strategy as I am. From ultras to super softs, one stop strategy. Nico Hülkenberg is in 6th, Kimi Raikkonen is in 7th. In 8th and 9th is Fernando Alonso and Sergio Perez, but as you guys see here, Sergio Perez is about to pass Fernando. Sorry, Fernando. And bringing up the rear end of the top 10 is the second Red Bull of Max Verstappen, who started very way back due to a penalty, as you guys know. In P4 at this very stage, it's so fun to say that. On the beginning of lap 29, Nico Hülkenberg is once again behind me. He passed to Charles Leclerc. But just notice that doesn't matter what I do, I can't get rid of this black and yellow Renault. He is like a leech. Literally, he's like a leech. No matter what I do, I can't get rid of him. But I know he was on the ultra soft tires and I was on the super soft. But still, come on, leave me alone, man. We're fighting it out here through the triple chicane. And as we head down the back straight, you guys can see I was a little bit of aggressive. I know I was. It's just... Guys, I wanted this P4, and with Perez pitting so late in the Grand Prix, he was really far behind. I don't even think he was in the points at this stage, so I needed to go good. But guys, we're heading to the final lap of the Grand Prix, and guys, I have to tell you this. Sorry for the camera shots jumping through the cars like that. It was on Hamilton, then on Vettel, and then back to us. But guys, get this. Lewis Hamilton, as he started his final lap, as he went through the triple chicane at the end of the home straight, his engine just said, poof! Lewis Hamilton is not going to finish the Mexican Grand Prix, and I have the chance to bag my first podium ever on F1 2018. But if Nico Hülkenberg has anything to say about it, he is not going to allow it. Just after the chicane, there was yellow flags because Lewis has pulled his car off on the left-hand side of the road. It was just a few meters ahead. It was just before the next chicane. But guys, Sebastian Vettel comes through to win the Mexican Grand Prix. Very well done, Sebastian. Very well done. But come on, jump back to my POV. It's a four-car scrap for P3. Daniel Ricciardo comes through in P2. And he has also done very well this Grand Prix. He couldn't catch Vettel, but that was a very well and solid drive. We head here through the double right-hander, going into the S section, and Nico Hülkenberg is on my rear end, guys. Guys, I had no rear grip at this stage. My rear tires were more than 70% worn. There was nothing I could do to have grip at this stage. So all I had was the little bit of power advantage over the Renault. He's going for a move into the final part of the stadium section. No, 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 no. The fireworks are going. The confetti is going for Sebastian Vettel, who won the Grand Prix. But I keep the position. Yes, yes, yes. It's going to be a first ever podium for Toro Rosso in this career mode and for myself. Let's go, baby. Yes, 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 yes. P3, let's go, man.
Okay, good job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
Guys, what a Mexican Grand Prix. I am speechless. My first P3. Let's go, baby. Come on. Yeah. But guys, I have to bring your attention to the points. Now that Lewis Hamilton didn't finish a Grand Prix, guys, look at the top. I'm going to go there right now. Go to the top. And also, Sergio Perez didn't even make the top 10. Look at the top, guys. 1 point separates the top three. Lewis Hamilton, Sebastian Vettel and Kimi Raikkonen are separated by one measly point. 1 point. And myself and Sergio Perez are separated by 6 points.
Fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you? Everything went your way today. It looked like you had a really good strategy for the race. You're surpassing all expectations. Can anything or anyone stop you? Do you think you were lucky not to end your race with that crash? Appreciate your time.
Why, thank you, Claire. I also appreciate your time. Guys, three drivers, two rounds to go. 1 point separating them from the world championship. Brazil and Abu Dhabi stand before us like a mountain, guys. A very fun mountain. But guys, I have to confess something. Guys, I love Abu Dhabi and Brazil. Honestly, I do. I really, really, really do. But no matter what I do, I cannot get into rhythm on those tracks, no matter what I do. But I'm not going to complain about it. I'm going to go in full steam and we're going to see what happens. Let's hear from Jeff.
That's a great result. You did really well. I don't think we can have any complaints with that performance.
Yeah, man, it was my first podium. You better be proud of me. But guys, that has been the end of this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. Like, subscribe, don't forget to ding the bell, and I'll see y'all for the Brazilian Grand Prix. Cheers! Stay in this town.